Hello, fans, and welcome to tonight's game between the San Francisco Dons and the Kansas Jayhawks. And, of course, here's our starting lineup.
Keep your eyes on these two small forwards, Brad. They're both very talented, and you can expect to see them go at each other all game long.
Tonight, we've got two big men that'll battle it out at the power forward spot. Number 33 might be one of the best floor leaders in the country right now.
Starting across from him tonight will be another great player that knows how to run a squad out there. It should be a great matchup throughout the night.
Well, partner, I say let's get to the action on the court and we'll see how this one plays out. All right, buckle up, folks. Here we go. Tip-off of the first half starts us off. They'll work it around the arc. Turnaround jumper.
Nothing but nylon. Nice, smooth turnaround jumper. The only negative, he's falling away. If he misses, he's got no rebounding ability.
Good job defensively. They just won't give many openings.
Pressure in the basketball.
Looking for a good shot. He shoots from the angle.
In and out with tough luck.
Farmer handles the pass.
Look at that spacing.
That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
Perfectly executed.
Get out of the way, baby. That was absolutely sensational.
On the outside. For the bucket. Perfectly executed.
Look at that! That's unbelievable, baby!
Now, looking for the ball screen, Dick.
Hey, it's a two-man game, Brad. So many teams incorporate it into their scheme because it works.
Perry handles the pass. Turnaround jumper. Kept alive. Way off target. Up and in. Number 12 takes the feed. Tries for two. The lay-in. He goes up with it. It'd be nice if he could get some assistance out there. That young man is doing it all for his team right now.
Right now, it's a one-man show. The other players need to step up.
Moving it around the perimeter. Jumped in front to take it away. It's a fast break possibility.
Terrific score off the fast break.
King receives the ball. Now trying to feed the low block. Goes up for two. 10 on the shot clock. Coach directing the defense now, Dick. There's the tempo for the game thus far.
That stat doesn't surprise me, Brad. The pace of the game has been pretty slow.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, they're really doing a great job packing it in, then a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Ten on the shot clock. And the ball goes out of bounds. And here we are, our team tempos. Looks like we've got an old-fashioned half-court game on our hands, Dick.
It sure does, Brad. It's always interesting to watch two teams like this square off. Neither team is going to want to push the pace, so we are sure to see the best from both sides.
Buries the deuce. Nice to have you along with us tonight. Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews alongside. I'm Brad Nessler. We got a good one going. Farmer receives the ball. Ten on the shot clock. Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc looking for the open jumper. As the fans chant.
Who says there's no such thing as a home court advantage? Dump it inside.
With the catch, nice execution on the spin.
I tell you, great spin move to the basket.
Let's see if they can get a good shot this trip.
I'll tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box.
Ten on the shot clock. For two, perfectly executed. On the outside. That spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin. Dump it inside!
Count's getting high and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Up and in! On the dribble, gives it up. Takes his jumper. Good for two. He puts up the three ball. He can't get the hoop to fall. Farmer comes up with it.
Nothing gonna come easy tonight, baby.
They are really playing for keeps. They work the perimeter.
He's got hops like you, man. He got hops like you.
It is pretty similar.
Wow. They didn't realize my partner was a high riser.
gave it up. Overplays on the pass, and he didn't get the steal.
Oh, he's humiliated. Poor job defensively.
The Jayhawks are all about half-court style.
They'll never force a shot and will rarely get into a running game, Brad. They realize that they can't play that style and be successful.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. What's even more important, they'll have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper. He takes the rebound. Looking for a good shot. He could not get more wide open. That is a dagger in the heart, that shot, Dick.
Hey, they lost focus here. They need a timeout to regroup, Brad.
Number 33 takes the pass. Now they work it around the perimeter. For the bucket. Off the rim and no good. Perry handles the feed. Looking to move it around the perimeter. Ten seconds on the shot clock.
Nothing but nylon. Nice, smooth turnaround jumper. The only negative, he's falling away. If he misses, he's got no rebounding ability.
On the dribble, gives it up. Tries for two. The lay-in. Pushes it up. Both teams are looking to get something going here. Work the perimeter.
Spacing's so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
That's definitely not the shot they were looking for, Dick.
Hey, Brad, their shot selection has been questionable. Too many outside jumpers. They've got to attack inside and then out.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Great anticipation defensively.
Gave it up.
I tell you, nothing like having those legs, man, where you bounce right off the floor.
The small forward with the ball. They work it around the perimeter. Open shot. Misses from beyond the three-point line. Perfectly executed. Time for our first half player matchup update, Dick. What stood out to you so far?
I'll tell you one thing. I don't see any disparity at all. They are so balanced. Both stars are really getting after it.
Had a momentary look from three-point land. Go and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that block shot.
On the dribble, gives it up. For two, perfectly executed. Farmer receives the pass. They work it around the perimeter. In the clear. He nails the tray. The small forward takes the pass. Gave it up. He gets the rejection. 10 seconds remaining on the shot clock. Nelson makes his first substitution.
I'll tell you what I like about him, Brad. He brings all kinds of energy to the floor.
The Jayhawks will step to the line for the first time. Misses the first. Johnson makes his debut into the game.
I tell you, this kid comes in with fire, Brad. He really knows how to bring it.
They look to get it to the inside. That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
And there's sort of a snapshot of our game tempo.
These teams are selectively pushing the ball and looking for transition opportunities.
Johnston handles the feed. Gets the feed down low. Now the turnaround jumper.
I tell you, what a nice turnaround jump shot. Soft as velvet, fading away, impossible to block.
The Dons really rely on a half-court attack at the offensive end, Dick.
They sure do, Brad. They like to work the clock and wait until the defense breaks down.
Bush receives the pass. On the dribble, gives it up. Ten on the shot clock. Tries for two. Up and in. Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
The Dons. Coaching staff would like the players to continue to play in this fashion. They believe that an up-tempo style must be avoided. They are a team that thrives in games with minimal possessions. The fewer the better is definitely a philosophy which they abide by. Guys?
Aaron Andrews, always close to the action. With all sorts of time. 10 seconds to put up a shot. Working it around the perimeter. They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper.
Hey, you don't have to be a space eater, a.k.a. a big guy, to get on board. You just have to be relentless.
Top of the circle, they work it around the perimeter. They'll work it around the arc. Goes up for two. The lay-in. Kicks it out. Ten on the shot clock. For two. Up and in. Looking for a good shot. Ten seconds on the clock. The lay-in. Number 55 handles the feed. Off the mark. Way out on top. Controlling the ball. For the bucket. Up and in. Billings handles the feed.
Look at that spacing.
Tries for two. In and out. On the outside. He shoots from outside. No good from the field. Gave it up. Ten on the shot clock. Now the turnaround jumper.
Opportunity for 2-for-1.
And there's what the game tempo is looking like tonight.
Long possessions, a few fast breaks is the reason for that, Brad.
Moving it around the perimeter. Goes up for two. Doesn't go. Shot clock is dead. Johnson handles the pass. The crowd's reaction says it all.
Hey, this crowd is full of discontent. That may be an understatement, too.
Russell pops back into the ballgame after a well-deserved rest.
Wow, he makes such an impact on his team when he's in the game. At both ends of the court, Brad.
He shoots from left of the circle. Jumper won't go. At halftime, the Dons lead by 14. We have had a whale of a contest so far in the first half, Dick Vitale. What do you have for a highlight of the half for us?
Watch the great work here on the inside for the score. I expect both these teams to do more of the same and continue to pound the ball inside in the second half.
Well, let's head back down to the court for the start of the second half. Kansas got beat up on the boards in the first half.
They made no commitment, Brad, to fight for the loose ball. I bet the coaching staff is going to hammer on the notion of aggressively crashing the boards for the rest of the game.
Farmer makes the substitution back into the ballgame.
Well, Brad, it's going to be interesting to see what kind of energy he comes with.
Dick, it's all about teamwork, and as we start the second half and take a look at our player matchup update, it's pretty even.
I'd say a really great balance out there because you look at the stars right now, they're getting the ball in the right place on the court where they can be effective.
The center handles the pass. Now the turnaround jumper.
Nothing but nylon. Nice, smooth turnaround jumper. The only negative, he's falling away. If he misses, he's got no rebounding ability.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, they're really doing a great job packing it in, then a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
He goes with a baby hook. 10 seconds to shoot. Well, let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Erin.
The Jayhawks are having a tough time, partly because they have not used the shot clock to their advantage. Their coach mentioned at halftime that their style of play confines them to playing in the half court. Dick, you also mentioned earlier that using the shot clock is the ideal style of play for them. Why have they gone away from this? That's the question that's puzzling all of us. Guys?
All right, thanks, Erin. The lay-in. The power forward handles the feed. Ten on the shot clock. That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
King is really turning some heads right now. He's on fire.
They need to keep feeding the ball. It's simple.
Russell handles the pass. Isolated on the outside, they're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. A little two-man action. He shoots from the elbow. Parker picks up the foul. First team foul. And there's a look at the backcourt comparison, Dick.
Hot day, Brad. You always want to know how the primary ball handlers are doing. Are they getting their team's quality shots, good opportunities? The team which takes care of these things usually is in a better position to win a game.
The Dons are going to be at the line for the first time in this game. Makes his first.
Makes those free throws count. He wants to go back on that campus as BMOC. Big man on campus, baby. Dump it inside.
And the ball goes out of play. The inbound play will come from the baseline.
I'll tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box.
Turnaround jumper.
I tell you, what a nice turnaround jump shot. Soft as velvet, fading away, impossible to block. Great composure to pass it despite the trap, Brad.
For two, perfectly executed. On the outside. Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
Rejects it. He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post player. Dump it inside.
With a jump hook, goes and gets it.
Fill the lanes. That's the only way they'll be able to get some fast break opportunities.
On the dribble, gives it up. Tries for two, and off the mark. Gave it up. They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper.
Nothing but nylon. Nice, smooth turnaround jumper. The only negative, he's falling away. If he misses, he's got no rebounding ability.
They work the perimeter. Goes up.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
Farmer receives the ball.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. What's even more important, they'll have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. He shoots from long range. He sinks another basket. What are they going to do with this guy, Dick?
I don't know, Brad, but they better do it quickly.
Chamberlain receives the pass. Cross court. Turnaround jumper.
I tell you, what a nice turnaround jump shot. Soft as velvet, fading away, impossible to block.
That's the luxury of the home court advantage. You have the crowd chanting, jumping around, fired up. It is awesome.
Who says there's no such thing as a home court advantage?
Looking for a good shot. He's in the clear. Not a wise decision to take that shot there.
I don't think the coach wants him taking that shot.
Now they work it around the perimeter. Goes up for two. Perfectly executed. Looking to move it around the perimeter.
It looks as though they have a shooter spotting up.
For two. Way off target. Up and in. Work the perimeter.
Spacing's so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
That spin move not successful, Dick.
I did a great job on the defense not allowing him to make that turn.
On the dribble, gives it up. Fake for the bucket. And he missed. Off the rim and no good. Well, I think it's time for some subs, Dick. The player fatigue is really setting in. He tries the three. Goes in. Jones handles the feed.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Tries for two. The lay-in. Dick, look at this highlight. A strong candidate for our Pontiac game-changing performance.
That's a fantastic play, Brad. That's definitely a candidate for the Pontiac game-changing performance.
Gave it up. Jones picks up the defensive foul. First personal foul. Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Brad and Dick, not too many differences between these two players. Seems as though they're almost canceling each other out on the floor. This now could come down to which team is stronger.
Thanks, EA, our third member of our team and our sideline reporter, keeping us up to date with what's taking place behind the scenes and around the bench. Good job, EA. Got them both.
He converts on that free throw line, and that's major.
Nelson receives the pass. They work it around the perimeter. with the catch. Nice execution on the spin.
I tell you, great spin move to the basket.
Number 21 handles the pass. Goes up for two. Up and in. Had a momentary look from three-point land. Too much time in the lane.
If it ain't there, move, young man.
They work it around the perimeter. Johnson may have escaped one there. Working it around the perimeter. For two, number 55 is charged with the foul. Everybody into the act right now, and you can tell by the cheerleaders on the sideline how things are going.
Isn't that what makes college so special? The enthusiasm of the cheerleaders, the mascot, everybody involved. Hey, Brad, you want to get to the line early and often. You end up getting your opponents into foul trouble, and it's also an opportunity to get some points.
Second one is no good. They are really controlling the boards.
That's right, Brad. Dynamite job of boxing out for position.
The Jayhawks are going to have to make some modifications here, Dick. They're going to have to throw out the idea of playing in the half court and get this into more of an up-tempo game.
They'll need some quick scores and defensive stops, Brad. That's the only way they'll be able to overcome this deficit. Playing up-tempo may not be their thing, but it's their only chance of getting back into this game.
Billings receives the pass. On the dribble, gives it up for the bucket. Way off target. Pushes it up. There's no fooling him. He gets the block in the post.
Look at him control the paint, Mr. Nestler. Get that stuff out of here, man.
The shooting guard with the ball. They'll work it around the arc. Tries one from three-point land. He missed. Gave it up. That spin move not successful, Dick.
I tell you, great job on the defense, not allowing him to make that turn.
Fantastic post defense, Dick.
Hey, just like you, Mr. Nestler, that's great D.
Looking for a good shot. tries for two. He is just lighting it up, Dick.
He's beating his man to the spot and hit the shots, Brad.
The shooting guard takes the feed, fakes it, goes up for two. Perfectly executed. On the dribble, gives it up. From the top of the circle, tickles the twine from downtown. Number 55 handles the feed.
Look at that spacing.
They get an open three. Nope. The shooting guard with the ball. Gave it up.
The defender is still applying great ball pressure, Brad.
Goes up with a shot. Jumper won't go. With lots of room, he misses from way outside. Baxter handles the feed. On the outside. For two. Can't get the shot to drop. Moving it around the perimeter. Using his size with a power move.
Oh, what a power goal. Jump stop. Takes the ball to the goal strong.
Brown receives the pass with a good look. Misses from long range. Cross court. For the bucket, the lay-in. There's such a variety of team styles these days, Dick. What are some of the qualities for a half-court team?
Half-court teams really will rely on each other. They'll not get any easy baskets, so they basically got to execute offensively by really moving the basketball and setting some good screens.
Johnston receives the ball. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, they're really doing a great job packing it in, and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
There's a shot clock violation.
They ran out of time because they made him think twice about where the ball should be passed.
Made him think three or four times, if you ask me. Cross court. Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
The small forward takes the feed. Isolated on the outside, they're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Tries for two. And in and out.
Dump it inside.
He takes it away. Number 12 takes the feed. He just can't escape the pressure.
The man can't get past it, Brad.
I'll tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box.
The ball goes out of bounds. They're set to throw it in from the side. On the outside. Turnaround jumper.
I tell you, what a nice turnaround jump shot. Soft as velvet, fading away, impossible to block.
Sideline inbounds. And that's a wrap for him.
They're going to miss his leadership.
Oh, Dick and the bench not happy about that play.
Oh, there's a lot of disappointment right there. They're hanging their heads, baby.
One and the bonus. Routine. Sinks it. Pushes it up. Goes up for two. The layup is good.
Up and inside!
Well, during pregame, we emphasized some points, and likewise at the half. Dick, now your final thoughts.
Brad, it's all about solid game plan. Teams who come prepared and know what the important points are will be successful more times than not. Having skilled players on your roster helps, but by no means is it mandatory.
Playing within yourself and your abilities is what it's all about. We say it time and time again. This play was awesome with a capital A, as Dick would say. It's also today's Pontiac game-changing performance. Dick, we know the TV business. You've got to have marquee matchups, but it's still about team basketball.
Well, that's how you win. You got to execute as a team. You got to make sure the right people shoot the shot. And I'll tell you, the people.